Hello friends, today I am going to start to discuss with you about rain water harvesting. Generally everybody knows that what is the value of the water. We usually say that the water is our lifeline. Water is natural resources. Water is national resource, water is life, and water is gift of nature to us. We all say this. But the main problem on earth is how to save the water. We not aware about it. So the problem comes when the awareness for the water conservation is not seen and not realized. We suffer more in that situation. So we need more requirement of the water, because the demand is more but the supply is specifically limited. So when the rainwater comes, we need to harvest it, and that is called rain water harvesting, right? Generally wells, groundwater and step wells are usually considered as natural or man-created water conservation steps. But the other steps like small dams, farm pond or the khet talawadi pond near the farm created by the farmer is called farm pond or the khet talawadi. So we need to conserve the water. Usually in India the natural proportion of the water is very limited. Some regions in Rajasthan, some part in Punjab, Haryana, some part of Uttar Pradesh, the Bundelkhand region, these regions are okay. In Maharashtra, the Vidarbha and Marathwada, Rayalaseema regions are suffering from acute shortage of water. So they need the basic requirement of the water. But in India, the problem is we are not aware about harvesting or conserving the rainwater in general manner. In urban area, from the terrace, pipe can be brought to the ground floor and can collect or accumulate the water of the rain. In underground tank, it is possible. At so many places we see this. But in a general manner, we are not aware about this. So we need to do this. So as we understand, the mediums of rainwater harvesting are well, step well, small dams, farm ponds accumulate the rainwater from terrace to the underground tank. These are basic possible ways, right? Okay. So water is possible to conserve through these mediums which I have stated here. Also we need to raise the groundwater level. In city area, new footpaths are made, and these footpaths are made from paver block of the yellow color, block of the cream color, block of the red color, we see, it is called paver blocks. The connecting the two blocks with the liquid, it makes the situation which allow the water inside the layer of earth, so the groundwater could accumulate in natural way. So these are the changes which are coming in the urban area these days, and it is usually required for development of our lifestyle. So we need to accumulate rain water as it is possible. Okay, now I want to discuss the objectives of rainwater harvesting. To increase the capacity of conserving groundwater level, and increase the underground water level, so in future when the acute shortage due to the drought or the summer season, we can fulfill our need of water that is required. So this is the first one. Second one is reduce the water pollution. Generally in India we have two main reasons for water pollution: releasing untreated dirt water with industrial waste in natural water resources, and the second one, release the water through sewer line and connect directly it with the natural resources of water, so the river, pond all become polluted. So we need to stop this. Okay, the third point is improve the quality of groundwater. Generally we need to think about what will be the quality of water, because the polluted water will enter inside the layer of earth. Thereafter, whichever the water will come out, it will be polluted. So we need to think about cautiousness for quality of groundwater which is accumulated in under layer of earth. Okay, the fourth point is save land routes from water logging. Generally we never care for reduces the water logging. Water logging means collect the water or allow the water to collect at one place on the roads. Try to make the roads clean so the water logging may not possible and water easily flow towards the river, because the collected water will create another problems for mosquitoes and so many problems. So we need to allow the water flow easily without obstacle, without creating obstacle in route of flowing water that we need. Okay, the next point is reduce the surface run of water. See, here earlier I said save the land route from water logging, and here I am saying reduce the surface run of water. Means there is contradictory. Run of water means flowing the water, and reduce means as possible as try to create the situation in which the groundwater level may come up and only water may not flow directly towards the ocean. That is the required, because the water logging, as I have told earlier, create the mosquitoes. But the accumulation of water in a large proportion of river, pond, lake, then it is useful. So to collect at one place and make it is useful is required as possible create the situation in which the water could absorb under the layer of earth. The next point is fulfill the requirement of domestic water requirements during summer and during long dry spell. Okay, why we need the rainwater harvesting? I have already stated just before in discussion of the rainwater harvesting that the situation of summer and the drought can be solved by accumulating water under the ground layer, because the rainwater if flowing will not be useful, but if it is accumulated at one place it will be useful. That is required to understand, we all have, right? Next point, fulfill the requirement of domestic requirement. Here I had not discussed this point. During the summer I said we need, but for which purpose? Our own requirement. We need drinking, cleansing and day-to-day lifestyle, we need the water. So we need, and for that purpose we need to accumulate water at one place, right? Next point, fulfill the increasing demand of water. As the population increase, demand of water is also increasing. And what can we do? We can do only one thing. First and last, accumulate the water at one place in proper treatment and with the proper awareness for not being polluted, and as much as try to accumulate in groundwater level. So in future, if the demand may increase, the need may be fulfilled, right? See, we have two options. First, to make the people aware about use of water become only when it is required, and the second one, do the harvesting. But alternate with this, we must need to be aware about reduction of the population so the demand may restricted. Is that clear? Okay. Next point is fulfill the increasing demand, and with that arrangement of rainwater storage. See, rainwater storage is possible in urban area in multi-storied building by creating underground level tank. So the rainwater could be accumulated at one place and it could be fulfilled the future need of people. Usually for urban area in big buildings, large buildings, water percolating is possible for accumulation of rainwater harvesting, because the water is coming with the dirt, it needs to be percolate, means filtration. So after the filtration the water will be pure, and as it is stored under the tank level, then it will again completely out of the dirt particles, then such water can be useful for us, right? It is possible to think about accumulation of water by water percolating and accumulating in the underground level. Is that clear? Okay. Now the next topic is which points we need to consider for water management. Now the question comes here, what is the meaning of water management? Water management means use the water as it is required and control unrestricted use. When it is not required, don't waste the water. That is the main essential part of the topic. But when it is required, must do it. Nobody says that you don't drink water, because the water is alive, so everybody need to drink. But to drink a half glass of water and to throw it, it is a wastage. So the water management is required to create the understanding of awareness for the problem may come in future for human life if we are not alert. Is that clear? Okay. Let's continue to discuss the points need to be considered for water management. First, use water economically. Economically means only when it is required we need to use, for gardens, vehicles. Here in garden we need for pouring the water everywhere on the plants. For vehicle, toilets and wash basin we need to clean and to throw the dirty water. But at that time, what can we do? We can use used water for flowing it in wash basin and toilets, and we can use cleaning the vehicle as possible by maximum restricting wastage of water. See, water is required to clean the vehicle, it is essential. But how to clean? Use only that part which may not be polluted, but the remaining part may not be wasted is required. So we need to use only when it is required. Second point, public awareness should be created in participation of water conservation. Without public support, any large contribution, without public support, without public awareness, without contribution of people, water conservation is not possible. So it is essential that to create awareness in mind of people that the water is in limited proportion and we need to preserve it. Next point, if possible, recycle the used water. Here I want to indicate one thing. Recycle means once the water is used, use it through treatment plant and again make it usable condition. So see, here nobody says that once used and the dirt water we need to drink. No, but after treatment we can use it to just cleaning point of view, nothing else. So the treatment plant is required to be established for recycling the used water. Next, save the reservoirs from pollution. See, the pollution of the water is just due to us and we need to stop it. So the farm ponds, the lakes, rivers and other water reservoir, water resources may not be polluted, but in the nearby area, usually in urban area, we see lakes and ponds. or the wells in the village area, it is required to be not polluted. To see that it must not be polluted, because the polluted water cannot be useful for us. The next point, increase the use of all units of water harvesting structures like wells, tube wells, khet talavdi means farm ponds, and other resources. Okay, here you understand wells, tube wells, khet talavdi here not used, but I must add step wells. These are the places where the rainwater is collected, harvested. Such kind of the places are needed to be developed. In the ancient period, the step wells were made. In Rajasthan, it is called Bavdi. In Gujarat, it is called Vav. Why such reservoirs, such step wells are made? Just to conserve the water, just to harvest the water. Because the water harvesting is essential for future generation or our daily needs to be fulfilled. Okay, next point is keep a watch on units those are using groundwater carelessly. Here the word carelessly is not given in your book, but I want to indicate, because the man's attitude is, in a general manner I am saying, not to indicating anyone, the man's attitude is to utilize the water. In one advertisement in the television, I have seen that the shower is coming. It was made in the glass top cabin. The village population living in the village was collected surrounding that glass cabin, and they were seeing the water is coming. Here it was giving the information about the advertisement, but I don't want to consider it as advertisement, but I want to say that the village people saw the water, they use it, and which proportion of water we use in shower, that water can be utilized. Instead of shower, we can collect in the bucket and use tumbler to use it for cleaning the body. Here in the advertisement, it was showing that the people were using that water, the amount of the water through which a person was taking bath through shower, the same proportion of the water had fulfilled the need of the many people in the village. It means here we need to think about understanding for use water as it is required and stop careless using. That is only indicated word here. Next point is prevent the deterioration of water storage unit. Deterioration means reduce the quality, and prevent means stop. Sometime the polluted water collected in the water storage unit, it is a low quality water which cannot be used for drink. Second problem we can see, the damaged pipeline are passing through and merging with the sewer water line. So you can think the dirt water will enter in the drinking water pipeline, and it will create problem for the health of the people. So here we need to think about make the repairing of the damaged pipeline immediately, so the water pollution must be stopped. In that way, uniformly, it is not possible for every area that we can stop dirt water, but local people should include their support and cooperate with the administration so the water resources development become possible and the management of the water resources also become possible. Generally, in the special region where the acute problem of the water, drinking water is more. So, the awareness of the people is essential regarding all these things. In this way, use of the water should be done in economic way. Second, various methods are required to be implemented for water conservation or water preservation. Third, whether rainfall comes or not, the water crisis is always with us because we are not using it carefully but carelessly we are using. So we need to create the awareness within our people's group. We have to conserve every drop of water because we have to understand that water is our life. This is the essential thing. Next one example is given in your book that I am indicating here, that in a Bidaj village, that is the name of the village, Bidaj village, they collected 2.25 crore liter water, means 2 lakh cubic meter of rainwater. They harvested and convert the entire dry area in greenery. See, this is the miracle. In Bidaj area, they created an association of villagers and solved the problem, primary problem of water. And by cooperation of social institutions of villages, they collected water. The village pond spread in 7 vigha. Vigha is the region where the farming is done. For the land, it is a measurement. Was depended by 20 to 22 feet. With the assistance from the financial help of the social institutions, 10 check dams, 11 farm ponds, drip irrigation in 25 hectares, pipeline in 10 hectares, deep plugging, small dams were constructed. See, just awareness of the people have created the miracle. About 2 lakh cubic water of the rainwater was stored. Just by the help of the people, the stony and the dry land became greener. This example has been set. About 154 vigha land of the Bidaj area got new facility of water supply. Due to that, the milk production increased by 12.5% in a year. Water storage increased by 20 to 30%. And here you can see that awareness of the people have again gave life to the agricultural activity and the milk collection activity. So the life of the people was saved. So this is the example here indicating the importance of the water conservation. Right, my friends?